I'm gonna need someone to help me. I'm gonna need somebody's name. I'm gonna need someone to hold me down. I'm gonna need someone to care. I'm gonna rise and shake my body. I'll start pulling out my hair. I'm gonna cover myself with the ashes of you, and nobody's gonna give a damn. Son of a bitch, give me a drink. One more night, this can't be me. Son of a bitch, if I can't get clean, I'm gonna drink my life away. For 17 years I've been going limber. 17 more will bury me. And somebody please just tie me down.
So two reasons that everything's manual brakes. We just talked about this in the truck, but I don't know if everybody overheard over the potential concerns for life-threatening safety. The vacuum-assisted brakes adjust with engine speed, and obviously we're going to have brakes and throttle on all the time, sort of overlapping each other. So we get rid of the manual brake, the power brakes, and turn them all manual brakes, so that we don't have that. Also, though, when you come into any of these bumpy sections, any part of the track.
Oh yeah, this is Dave. He owns the place, and he's really fast in his little red Evo. Here's a great aerial view of the beginner courses, starting with a circle where we learn left foot braking to make the car come in and outside on the track, and then figure eight, which is slightly more difficult version of the same thing, and then a long straight where we learn to use non-assisted brakes and actually stop the car without flying off the end of the track with He-Man legs.
You can't move it. The whole point of this is to teach you that left foot braking will turn the car more than anything else. The wheel is just kind of a suggestion. It doesn't actually do shit unless you put weight over it, which is the whole point of the left foot brake, right? The other thing is the throttle. You're just going to go full throttle, fixed throttle, okay, second gear in both of the cars, and your left foot is going to do all the work. So you're going to have the wheel turn, full throttle, and then your left foot is just going to, very finite modulation. You'll feel that, and you'll feel the exact point where, okay, this is where the car is rotating. The back of the car got light, so it's getting a little bit of rotation, and that's exactly where you want to hold it. You just want to do three perfect circles and then get out. Okay, we're each going to do two times. Unless you get it on the first time, then you're done, because this is boring. No one wants to do this. This is only to teach you that left foot braking is God. It's going to do everything for you.
Let me sum up everything else he says in this driver's meeting super fast. When doing the donut in a circle with everything fixed, more brakes tucks the car to the inside of the corner, and less brakes lets it drift to the outside of the corner. More brakes tucks the car in, less brakes lets the car go out. And that's the big lesson for this. Let's go drive. Let's get a little bit of perspective for the straight with a Civic on it. We're going to drive up and down this a few times for each driver, learn how to manhandle manual brakes by pressing super hard with your left foot to get used to that, and then move on to the next track.
Pressure these brakes, it doesn't do anything. You all feel that you have to like horse leg this thing to get it to stop, right? So adding a little bit of brake all the time is good, and then you're just going to feed in the brake that's going to rotate the car, and then as you're counter steering, then you're coming off the brake, okay? Then you're your car is going to rotate, then you're adding on brake to get that rotation back the other direction. And it's just a constant rhythm, a repeat of that, left and right, left and right. So you're on the brake, off the brake, on the brake, off the brake. I know, whatever.
While we really did enjoy the Civics and we really did appreciate them, we just had to sneak something in rear-wheel drive, which you already probably saw in a previous episode here.
Yeah! Ah! Oh, that was rougher than I thought.
Anyway.
Welcome to another episode of Lone Star Drift. I'm here with Aaron Smith.
Watch it crumble, see the drowning, watch the fall. I feel just terrible about it, there's sarcasm. Let it burn. Gonna make a toast when it falls apart. I'm gonna rain my glass upon my heart. Then someone shouts, that's what they get.
Probably take a mid to wide line on it to set you up here. Now this is going to be one of the most difficult turns on the track right here around this turn. You're going to want to do a weight transfer. So turn left and then right, and that's going to get you tucked in here. You're going to use a lot of left foot brake, and we're going to want to stay very much inside. If you don't go inside, you're going to see that mud pit there. And then we're going to go stay outside here. This is a kiwi corner with a little bit of bank. So it's going to be a left two. And then what I think we're going to do is we are going to hang a right, and then this right here is going to be pretty bumpy, so, and a little bit off camber, so you want to be kind of mindful with your steering. And that's going to turn us onto the slalom. And then what we're going to do here on the slalom is finish the slalom just like you guys have been doing today, except we're going to change the slalom up a little bit. It's going to be some gate. Car 5 clear. You'll see that some players are not playing opposite of the other. If you like to gamble, I tell you how you land. You win some, lose some, it's all the same to me.
That's the way I like it, baby. I don't wanna live forever. And don't forget the Joker.
So I started rallying in 2004 when I was 17. It was in response to playing copious amounts of Gran Turismo 3. And just becoming completely infatuated with the idea of rally. This was just barely pre-YouTube, so there was no real way to watch videos of rally at that time other than like find them on somebody's website, you know, and download like a 200 pixel, you know, like potato camera shot of some rallying and a few videos here and there, and became just completely obsessed and sort of opted to spend what I would have spent on going to college on racing rally cars, which was an interesting choice by my parents to support that. But we ran the Pikes Peak Hill Climb. It was my third race ever in 2005. I've run it every year since, except for this is 2016 will be my first year not racing. But we ran Pikes Peak for a few years, did a few rallies, and realized pretty quickly that the only way to make a career in motorsport, specifically in rallying, was going to be to build something. And Texas is entirely lacking in rally, with the exception of one awesome event that we used to have up in North Texas. But the problem is the whole state is privately owned. So we have a lot of different class offerings, and starting at a half-day class all the way up to a four-day class. We have a 2.5 hour that we've done on a Groupon promotion, but other than that, it's like the roller coaster ride. 2.5 hours in a rally class is not nearly enough. But most folks start around a half-day class, depending on what their level of interest is or what what they can afford. The half-day class is essentially, it's like our two-day rally school crammed into 4 hours. So everything we do is like drinking out of a fire hose. There's just so much to learn. But the half-day class is a lot in a really short period of time. It's a great way for folks who think they might be interested in rally or have some idea of you know, their level of interest, a great place to start. And then we've got, of course, our 1, 2, 3, and 4 day rally schools. The 4 day rally school is like a season plus worth of seat time crammed into 4 days.
All right. One go. And we're off into a tight left into right two minus. Repeat, right two minus. Very tight right. 20. Medium left here. Medium left. Eyes up. Long straight. 70. How do you think you're doing so far, Aaron?
I'm doing pretty well. We're still on track.
Good. Comfortable with the car?
Your car yet.
Yeah, fabulous. Looking nice. Flat through here. Flat through here. Easy ride and a very tight left. Very tight left. Hard on the brakes. Hard on the brakes. Nice work. Good, easy. Watch the tree on the outside. Eyes up here.
Oh, man, there's a tree.
Right entry, hairpin here. Do you think you're doing better on the second half? Stay to the right. You think you're doing better this half?
We're doing pretty well. We're on the first half. How do I know which side?
Sure, right. Yeah, good point. I think you're doing quite well, certainly compared to our first driver, Hunter Cash. You seem to be doing quite quicker, much
all
more
right.
Comfortable.
Is this flat out?
Easy into here, and then nice and slow into this corner.
Oh,
medium
a
speed right.
Oh,
yeah, there you go. Now flat through here, flat through here. You're going to have a flat right now. Flat right. Dabber brakes here. Eyes up there, staying to the left here. Watch out, nice medium speed right.
Shit.
Yeah, it's a bit dusty. Would you say it's lower visibility coming back than it was going in?
Yeah,
good.
A lot lower.
Yeah, we have a creek here that you didn't drive into, so you've certainly set a record so far.
Woohoo!
First creekless drive and stop before the horses. Well done.
There we go.
Fabulous. Fabulous. Do you think that's going to set a good, reasonable time for the rest of the
field? Well, I think we're definitely in first place. There's no way that we're not.
There was no point where you stopped for 15 seconds on track, so
No.
We're off to a
We're
good
doing
start.
Pretty well. We're still alive.
I had a rough day, but but that's life, it happens. Woke up on the dark side of my mattress. I guess I forgot to set my clock. Overslept, almost lost the job. Been to top it off, I'm kinda hungry. But can't eat till I find my money. It's in my wallet, but my wallet ain't in my pocket. Can't remember the last time I saw it. And they don't want me in a bad mood. Afraid that it'll spread and everyone will catch an attitude. They got them all singing the same tune. Thinking I should go and start a fire in the break room. Co-workers make me sick. And the manager really ain't shit. But I can't quit, so I'm hiding in the basement. Holding on to my face like fuck this place. Every day can't be the best day. Do what you can right now, don't hesitate. That's why we try to make love and get paid. Take the bad with the good, now let's play. Every day can't be the best day. Do what you can right now, don't hesitate. That's why we try to make love and get paid. Take the bad with the good, now let's play. Hell no, I ain't going to school. The teacher's a jerk, he must think I'm a fool. And all the kids mess with each other always, all day. Class warfare up and down the hallways. And if you ain't popular, nobody talks to you unless they mocking you. Not even the bus driver or the hall monitor. I might as well climb inside my locker, huh? It's a bad day, bad week, and a bad month. Don't nobody wanna trade with my bag lunch. Someday I'ma be so cool, but for now I got cheap shoes, so I keep losing. Girls give no love to a poor man. It's a prison, the clock is warden. And it won't get no better when I get home. So I listen to the voice in my headphones. It say, every day can't be the best day. Do what you can right now, don't hesitate. That's why we try to make love and get paid. Take the bad with the good, now let's play. Every day can't be the best day. Do what you can right now, don't hesitate. That's why we try to make love and get paid. Take the bad with the good, now let's play. Can't dance with an upset stomach. The overdraft notices just kept coming. Somebody broke into the porch and stole a chair. Top of your head stopped growing hair. Broken glass, computer crash. The car won't start and the tires went flat. Dog got loose, brought back a dead cat. Daughter found it and had a panic attack. Plus you ain't had sex in how long? Afraid to admit that the fire's all gone. Better half is talking about separate. You wish you could take it back to yesterday. You're not alone, it's hard as hell. Don't waste no time feeling sorry for self. We'll be right here with you through your war. Cause you're the one that we make this music for. Now turn it up. Every day can't be the best day. Do what you can right now, don't hesitate. That's why we try to make love and get paid. Take the bad with the good, now let's play. Every day can't be the best day. Do what you can right now, don't hesitate. That's why we try to make love and get paid. Take the bad with the good, now let's play.
A huge thank you to Rally Ready Driving School. We want to just say thank you. We had an amazing time. If you want to come learn how to drive rally cars, come down to Austin, Texas. Dave will show you how. Everybody, did you have a good time?
Yeah!
All right, thanks. See you later, everybody. Bye.
We are Rally Ready!
All right.
Cool. Let's do one more for safety.
All right.
Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed. We had an amazing time at the Rally Ranch. If you are not done with your attention span yet, here's an entire Mustang video of Aaron Smith. Enjoy. P.S. Thank you so much, sponsors. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, sponsors. Read the sponsors. Please look at all these sponsors. Thank you, sponsors.
As a drifter, I can confidently say we are all idiots. In this episode, we take Aaron Smith's Texas street legal car down to the Rally Ready Ranch just outside of Austin, Texas to put it through its paces on dirt. Now this car does not want to go over anything larger than half an inch. It's low to the ground, for a Mustang I guess, hits the frame rails and the exhaust on basically everything, and while it did really well out here, the bottom of the car was not happening. But here we go. I hope you enjoy this episode of Lone Star Drift. Thank you for watching. Oh, and it probably helps. Aaron Smith doesn't give a fuck about the bottom of this car.
Yeah. Oh, that was rougher than I thought.
Anyway.
Welcome to another episode of Lone Star Drift. I'm here with Aaron Smith.
What's up?
All right. Sorry about the wind today. It is very windy. But here we have, he won, I think, round two of Texas Street Legal in 2015. This is the car that won. It's a very fine automobile. How many ponies does this baby have underneath the hood?
I don't know, like 220?
All right. It's a pretty simple car. It follows the Texas Street Legal rulebook pretty well. I guess. I don't know. It's a basically, I think, coilovers. It has BC coilovers. It has basically a stock motor with bolt-on junk on it. It's caged. And probably a clutch. Does it have anything else cool?
Stock clutch, stock rear end, just Doug Vanderbrink arms and stuff.
Oh, so he has crazy steering angle and then everything else is stock, including the clutch. Well, that's really cool. The car is, it works pretty well. How well would you say it works?
Once I got it dialed in, it works really well for what it is. It wouldn't be a Pro-Am car at all, but for Texas Street Legal, it's great.
Yeah? How much money do you have in this thing?
Initial purchase was like $2,000 or something, and then probably another $3,000 total on suspension and junk.
So you have about $5,000 in the car, and probably $2,500 of it was the knuckles.
Yeah, at least that much, and then the cage.
Okay, so about half the money in this entire car is in the knuckles. If you were to do it again, would you build the same car for Texas Street Legal, or would you build something else?
No, I'd do another S197. The 05 and up Mustangs are way better. Yeah. So.
What is so different about the SN197s?
The rear end starts a lot better. It's a three-link as opposed to this like quadrubine thing that they have on this one. It just works a ton better. The car makes better power all the time, stock, and it's much simpler to get angle. You just like do knuckles on them really easily, which there are knuckles available for these now, but they weren't available when I was doing it. So.
And is this a 5.0?
No, it's a 4.6.
Is the 5.0 or the 4.6 better?
The older 5.0 is a little slower than this one, but the new 5.0 is much better. So,
let's look at this thing. The wheels look pretty rad. What kind of wheels are they?
They're Rotas.
They're Rotas. Well, they look pretty rad for Rotas. Yeah. I think they're powder coated white. Is there anything else cool about this car?
Not really. It's just kind of a boring car that's fun to drive.
All right. I don't know what else to say. It's a Mustang.
Yeah.
Let's kick it again.
Okay.
All right. All right, let's go watch it drive. Yay. Forgot to do the engine bay shots. Y'all want to bring a camera over here? All right, let's point out stuff on this engine.
All right.
People are probably very curious what a stock Mustang motor looks like. So.
And we're off the line, not going anywhere in a hurry. We're into a medium left, into a tight right, repeat tight right. Got a tight right-hander here. And a medium left, a nice medium speed left here, flat on exit. Nice up flat on exit. I can't hear much of anything that's happening in this car. I can't see shit. Aaron, how would you say you're doing so far?
I don't know, the car's dying, that's bad.
The car feels quite grouchy, I must say. That was a very large rock that just went under the vehicle. I also can't see or feel anything as all of my senses are dulled by the copious amount of dust currently pouring into the vehicle.
The day wouldn't be over without a retarded burnout, so take it, Aaron!
If you made it to the end of this video, go subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. P.S. Huge shout out to rallyready.com. We really appreciate you letting us use your facility, and if you want to learn the art of rally, car control on dirt and gravel and whatever else, hit Dave up over there. He will teach you everything. Thanks, Dave.